So I held a poll on facebook.com/engineeringexplained to see what you guys wanted my next videos to be on, and it seemed like a popular topic was suspension variance. So I wanted to get into suspension variance, but then I was thinking, and in order to explain suspensions well, I'm going to need to explain tire alignment or wheel alignment first. That way, I can eliminate a lot of questions once I get into suspensions. So I'm going to go into four major parts of wheel alignment, and the first one is going to be camber, and these will help clear things up once I start going into suspensions, making it easier to understand and hopefully eliminating some questions. So first off is camber. Now, camber is the angle of the tire with respect to the vertical axis of the car. So positive camber is when the top of the tire is leaning outward and the bottom of the tire is inward. So if you're looking at a car straight on, you're going to see the tires bowing out, and that would be positive camber. Now, negative camber is the opposite, and the top of the tires would be inside and the bottom of the tires would be going out. So most vehicles use positive camber a very slight amount. Now, one thing I should note is that these are very exaggerated. It's not going to be anywhere near this on the majority of cars. But this is just so you can get the idea. And most vehicles will have a slight amount of positive camber. And that has to do with the steering axis inclination, which will be my next video. So watch that, and that will explain why most vehicles use positive camber. On the other hand, some racing and off-road vehicle applications, they will use either slightly negative or no camber. And that's for reasons such as you'll have a little bit wider stance and you can have greater stability. If you've got the inside of your tires coming in and you go around a corner at 100 miles an hour, then the car's going to want to roll. So with racing or off-road applications where stability is pretty critical, you might have negative or neutral camber. And that's camber.